Hey, what's going on? I'm Devin.
I'm Jeff.
And we are Basic Bros Reaction. Hey, what is going on? It is Basic Bros Reactions here today. And today we have a special reaction as a thank you for us hitting 4,000 subscribers. We are going to be doing another intro slash helpful slash unhelpful guide to this week, or this winner for this time is...
Goals. Mets. Yeah.
So we did a poll, which if you're a subscriber, you know we do a couple polls a week usually. And we did a poll over which like girl group or soloist did you guys want to see us do an intro guide to whatnot, and the winner was Mamamoo.
Yay!
So it'll be our third ever and our second female. Our first females was Little Mix, so if you haven't checked it out, the link will be right there to check out our Little Mix one. And then we also did a guide to EXO, so we'll be putting that link right there for EXO as well. So we're really excited. We are big fans of Mamamoo. We kind of came into the channel knowing a little bit about Mamamoo and enjoying them and whatnot, but just doing reactions and just them blessing us with comeback after comeback, with great music and checking out their solo work. We just have really grown to really appreciate them, and they're just like one of our top girl groups. And
even so, that we tried to do that solar challenge, was it?
We did the spin it out challenge.
Oh
yeah,
God,
we
yeah.
tried that, and you know, on our TikTok, you know,
yeah.
that's we started our TikTok based off of that. I mean, yeah. We haven't really done much with it afterwards, but that's okay because we did it for her, we did it for Mamamoo. So, we are just really excited to kind of once again just continue to learn more about them, because I feel like we know quite a bit, but it'll be good to get just a little bit more of a refresher, kind of learn more details about them, which hopefully this helpful guide will give us some more information, some helpful information, because we've done an unhelpful guide, and it was like the title says. I thought that like when they said unhelpful guide, it was like joking.
Yeah.
But it was very unhelpful, the one that we had done before. So... So we're excited, and so I guess we will get into this helpful guide to Mamamoo in 3, 2, 1. The little intro.
It's me. Welcome to a new video on the channel. Have you ever seen Mamamoo perform and thought to yourself?
Oh, she looks so young in that one.
I think I'm gay now, all while step on me. Have you ever thought of standing then, but you're not sure where to begin? Well, I'm here to help you with a new Mamamoo guide for people who want to stare on new moves. Let's get started.
Yes, that's new moves.
Yeah. Yeah.
Under a small company called RBW Entertainment.
They look so young right there. Look at her, she looks like a baby.
No.
Their debut EP was called Hello, and they released a music video for their title track, Mr. Ambiguous. Their fans are called Boo-Boos.
Okay, that's why they have the radishes and all that stuff. Okay.
Let's start with the members. Sola is the oldest member and leader.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Not biased.
She was born on the 21st of February 1991.
That's
how
she's the oldest.
Sola is the main vocalist. Visual and, like I've said before, leader of the group. Can we talk about girlies vocals?
Wow.
Damn, she didn't come to play.
I remember that performance on Swingdom. We did a reaction to it.
Sola is probably one of the more crackhead members of the group.
Oh my God.
They're all definitely crackheads.
Why do they call them that? What the heck?
In fact, the reason I found out about Mamamoo was because of the viral video of her getting ignored by Jimmy. It was love at first sight.
Oh my God, that's so cute.
Where she posts random challenges and a video on her pole dancing because it was doing it like her.
Whoa.
What a queen. She has has some solo tracks you should check out because it's amazing.
Oh. She's so cute.
She
oh my gosh.
Yeah. Well, she's my bias. Even though they're all incredible.
Summer supported the album of agenda this month, but she performed Fire by BTS and decided to post.
Oh, we'll have to watch do a reaction to it.
Wow. She's so different with dark hair.
I know.
Jesus! Dang! That's awesome.
Mobile was born on December 22nd. She's a main rapper, main dancer, and second visual in Malibu. She originally auditioned to be a vocalist, but she became a rapper instead. Mobile writes her own rap, which
makes her Mobile
one of the best girl rappers of this generation.
It's so crazy that she wasn't originally a rapper.
Beautiful voice. Wow.
Love like her deep, voice.
I like her singing sleep.
Selfish last May. It was a collaboration with Silji. You all should stream it because Selfish is a bomb of the lyrics are very meaningful.
I love that vibe already. Summary.
Incredible dancer.
Dancer of Malibu. Weeen is literally the epitome of a puppy, and if I didn't know any better, I would totally think she was a magpie. Weeen's laugh is also the cutest thing. I melt every time I hear it. Weeen also proclaimed herself as the queen of snacks. I mean, she's a snack so less she has a voice of an angel. Can we talk about when she sang Honey by Kennedy with Flo?
Hearing them individually, you can just hear how they would meld so great too.
What's RBW?
The company they're under.
Such a talented woman. Like, the energy she radiates is just wow. that works. Once a lot, Rihanna. And when I say a lot, I mean she'd probably sell everyone in Bondaloo some $2 just so she could meet her. Let's make it happen, y'all.
She really kind of gives me some Rihanna vibes. Like,
yeah,
just that kind
does.
Of.
Which isn't correct, by the way. Also, I don't believe in stupid beauty standards, and I believe everyone can be an idol as long as they're talented. So when she was told she didn't fit the beauty standards, she decided to make her own. What a woman. Phew. Also, some of you may know her blog called Twit.
Okay.
It's the song of the year, so y'all should stream it.
She exudes such a strong vibe. I love that. Mm-hmm.
Albums. They decided to make one album per season that represented all members.
Mm-hmm.
Every member had one self-written solo track on the album they represented.
That's so cool.
This album was the first one. It's called Yellow Flower. Her album represented spring. It came with the bomb called Starry Night and her solo track, which is my favorite solo track for your information. The Car.
This is like the song that kind of got me back into them.
Oh yeah, I do love that.
Such a beautiful video.
Yeah.
After Hwasa came Moon Bile. Moon Bile's album was called Red Moon and represented summer. If you haven't listened to Egotistic yet, you totally should. It's a bop and a half. Her solo track was Selfish, which I've mentioned before.
I think this is like one of Jeff's favorites.
Oh yeah, I heard this it over and over.
Album, can we talk about Moon Bile's vocals on Morning? The album has the most underrated title track ever. Windflower is such a bop and everyone sleeps on it. Her solo track is called Hello. It's very nice and calm and the only solo track that hasn't had a music video so far. So RBW, they're all waiting.
The
latest
like
album
that.
Is White Wind. The album representing Winter and Leaves solo track is on here. Can we talk about comedy? This song never gets old. I love the choreo and they all really shine the zero. Now that we have a music video for Weeds track 25, I recommend you all to stream it. We see the video is so aesthetically pleasing to watch.
I love this video
but I still feel the need to tell you all that Bondaloo is the gayest girl group out there. Like, there's a reason most of the fandom exists out of lesbians. Disclaimer, I'm not trying to fuel any shipping agendas and I'm not trying to insinuate that they're all gay. I'm just saying that they tend to have gay interactions on stage. Just crackheads in general. Like when they really just betrayed their friendship for ice cream. Or their Amaro Yes music video. Mamma Mia.
Yeah. Oh my god, Jesus.
I totally forgot to write the whole song they wrote about each other's hearts. Legends.
They're so crazy.
They are.
They're so clever.
This generation that everyone stands out. There is no member who shines more than others. They always make
That's
sure
so true.
Shine. Here are some random facts for you to know. Sola's stage name comes from Do Re Mi Fa Sola. She chose the name because she's in charge of the high notes of the group. Moonbyul is friends with Jin from BTS. They're in a 92-liner group chat together. We love legends supporting legends. We have performed at Masked Singer, and even though she was sick, she still sounded like an angel. Plus, is allergic to pets and has a fake pet lion who she mentions when the other members talk about their own pets. This was my guy for Marvel.
That's funny.
I hope you all learned something from this and maybe decided to stand. I might want to make a video explaining their slightly problematic past so that new movements can be educated and to make sure people know more about the stuff that actually happened and the stuff that made up six scientists like to spread fake accusations. I hope
so
you enjoyed the video and please comment.
You reacted to that, you and Jeff, yeah.
Section below. I'm really curious.
I
anyways,
so beautiful.
Some suggestions for types of videos you want to see on the channel.
And they were just killing it vocally.
They're so cute. I love like seeing like their personalities. Their personalities is definitely like they're definitely people that you could hang out with, I feel like, and just have such a fun time with.
Yeah,
especially Solar. I think she's just so funny.
Yeah.
She's so cute. I would have not ever thought I didn't know that she was the leader, honestly. Like I didn't know she was the oldest and leader because she's just like so silly whenever I
yeah,
see her.
Yeah, she has
before.
Like such a like young vibe feel
yeah.
to her and everything
yeah.
that is like really hard to imagine her being the leader and being the oldest too, because
mm-hmm.
there's just like, you know, just this playfulness to her personality. So
yeah.
it's just like
it's so cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think my favorites would be, I don't know, it's hard to pick one, but I think Hwasa is probably my favorite.
I think yeah, he's
I just
yeah.
love her.
Solar is still mine. But I just
yeah,
I love all of them.
Yeah.
And kind of like we were saying in the video, it was really cool hearing them to each individual, like I mean like we've heard them all sing individually in the tracks, but just to kind of hear them in the solo stuff and just
mm-hmm.
highlighting their voices, because then you can just see how their voices mesh so
mm-hmm.
well together
yeah.
and how they like harmonize and how they just like, it's just really cool to see. And it's really cool to see their kind of, even within the reactions that we've done, the evolution of their sound, their style, and
mm-hmm.
everything. And I mean, I think that even if we go back, because I've watched some of their older videos,
mm-hmm.
and they're completely different than what
oh, really?
They are now. And they're like a lot more quirkier and whatnot. And so we have to react to some of their really older stuff. So let us know down in the comments some of your favorite older Mamamoo videos. But it's just really cool to kind of see just how they've like grown and their sounds and everything like that, and how, you know, they've always been decently respected, I feel like, in the K-pop industry, but just in the last couple of years, how they've become like one of the top girl groups, from being like, you know, just kind of like, you know, oh, Mamamoo, they're good singers and everything, to like Mamamoo, like they're great singers, they're great performers, they have great personalities, they can dance, like just to see them be respected for as a total package, as opposed to just vocals or just being kind of quirky or whatnot, to see them fully appreciated by so many people, it's just really cool to see.
I agree, yeah. I really like that guide. It was definitely helpful
in
getting to know them more as a cohesive group and what their individual, like, you know, backgrounds were and stuff.
Thank you guys so much for subscribing. Make sure to continue to share our videos, comment, like them, you know, give us suggestions, comments, because like I said, we look through every comment. We're constantly putting up polls too for our subscribers. You guys help to kind of help dictate where the direction our channel goes to and whatnot. And so we just want to thank you guys from the bottom of our hearts for your constant support.
Yeah. So thanks again. So don't forget to hit the like, the subscribe button, and then ding the bell so you don't miss any notifications from us. And thanks again for tuning to Basic Braids Reaction.